like, share, comment, and subscribe.
Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see about MRTG. So, how you are going to configure a multi-router traffic grapher. So, this is a open source tool which can help you to monitor a device interface traffic incoming and outgoing inbound and outbound bandwidth utilization. If you have example, say that you have edge router, maybe you have the firewall, maybe you have so many devices on the network, you wanted to monitor their interface bandwidth. Like example, say I have ISP is providing internet connectivity, I would like to say that how much bandwidth I'm utilizing on that ISP. So just I can provide you the graphical representation of that traffic, so how much utilization is going on at that point of time. So you can see that report over here using this MRTG. This is an open source tool. This MRTG will work on SNMP, so the simple network mapping protocol will use a queries to run on the remote device and get this details and configure and works on here. Let's see this, how you can install and configure this configuration in order to get this done. So basically I have one virtual machine over here and another virtual machine on the remote. So I will configure both the remote servers as a MRTG interface monitoring, and I will put some copy from here to there and see this, how the utilization helps over here. See this. So in order to install your MRTG packages, let's see this, you have to use M and install net SNMP, because the SNMP is required and SNMP utilities are required. Okay, and MRTG package, install the HTTPD service. So we have to start the HTTPD service in order to get this web browsing capability. So these are the packages need to be installed, and the packages has got installed. Now you have to just configure your SNMP configuration on this machine, and let's go ahead and copy /etc SNMP and SNMPD dot configuration file. To basically I'm just backing it up, this in case something goes wrong I can revert it back. And I don't want this configuration file, actually I just delete that configuration file, and I'm just going to create a new configuration file of the SNMP. Into the SNMP configuration file, and now systemctl enable SNMPD dot service and systemctl start SNMPD dot on service. Okay, verify this status, how it is running. So it's running fine, there is no line number 8, there is some warning. Let's see this, what is that? Actually this spelling is wrong over here. This is peer, not peer. Okay, now again restart this one and verify the status, all looks good. Okay, now we have to verify that whether SNMP is working or fine. SNMP walk -v2c, the version is 2c, and the community string what we are using over here, it is the techarkit, and provide the machine IP address which you are querying and say that system and you are able to get some replies using this MIBs, that's fine, which means that the SNMP is working fine. Okay, and now what you have to do is that you have to make this configuration generator. So you have to make the configuration generate this configuration, MRTG configuration, using this CFG maker configuration tool. So this CFG maker is a tool which is used to create the MRTG configuration files. Okay, so this has so many options over here. Let's say that CFG maker, I'm just using SNMP hyphen options equal to 2, and just say that if reference, which means that what is the reference this has to take. The reference it is should take is that interface description. So interface description, in the sense, whenever it is querying the remote machine, it should gather the interface description, what is written on that interface, and get the details from there. Okay, and provide this remote machine's string, community string, @ remote machine's IP address. In this case, I'm just querying my internal system itself, that's why I'm just giving this one, and I'm just redirecting this configuration to the MRTG directory and say that localhost.cfg. So which means that I'm just going to monitor my local interface itself, that's why I'm just generating this MRTG configuration for localhost itself. So it is going to be query this local machine itself and get the details over here, which gets, and now you can go and see this MRTG and localhost.cf configuration file over here, and which is the interface is enabled. The interface would be get the details over here. This is the interface details which is got, see this, and the interface settings is 125 MB, and traffic analysis, this is the HTML configuration path. Now you have to edit this configuration MRTG and localhost and say, and uncomment this one over here and say that I just wanted to enable this one into the default configuration file. I don't want to use any other stuff over here. And if you enable this one, your graph will get into the bits. The values would be in bits, not in bytes. Okay, if you want to change that, you can change, you can delete all this unknown part of it if you want to, if you don't want. So you can just delete this interface. I click in the sense loopback interface and all the stuff, you can delete it, because this does not make any sense over here. Or let it be, that does not make much difference, because those are commented lines. Okay, to make it this file clean, that's why I just deleted those lines. Now our configuration file is ready. Now we have to go to this generate this enable this querying, and it generates some configuration files over here. Before that, we have to enable and start this httpd service. Okay, systemctl start httpd.service, and I'm just going to enable this service as well, and again I'm just going to restart it once again. Now verify the status of httpd. Okay, our service is running fine, no problem. Now you just make this configuration generation using this for loop, because you have to run this so many times. Instead of running so many times, you can simply run all this stuff in a single go. Okay, it's example, say that I'm just declaring the value over here, I equal to 1. If it is 1, then I is greater than or equal to 3, then add the values plus plus over here, and do env environment language equal to C and say mrtg configuration slash etc slash mrtg localhost dot configuration file. This is what it needs to be, generate the configuration file over here and say this done. Now your this configuration files will be generated on this html that slash var slash www.html path. You can go and see this www.html. You can see this, the configuration has been generated over here. See this, the day png, month png, week png, yearly png. So these are the png files which will show on the front end side, and the index file you have to generate over here. Before that, if you want to allow or deny this web page access to the any internal or external case, you can just use this allow or deny roles on the HTTP configuration file if you want, or else leave it, not a problem. By default it's allow all the locations, okay. And now just change this ownership of these files, all these files, to the Apache and say slash var wwhtml. So this is the files you have to change the configuration, and systemctl. If you want, again you can just verify and restart this httpd service. And now you have to generate this configuration path over here. So the same one, environment language equal to C and slash usr bin mrtg path. This is the mrtg path exactly, slash etc slash mrtg, and your configuration path where your configuration path is. And you have to specify the log file, which file you would like to use as a log file, and mrtg slash var slash log. You can use mrtg folder, and in this mrtg you can use any file over here. Maybe example say that mrtg underscore a, I just would like to use. And cache file you have to use, configuration cache file, which means that which will actually cache and process this database to RRD database, okay. By default which uses RRD database of the mrtg configuration, and mrtg dot, okay. So this is the configuration you have to write over here and verify that, okay, no errors, that's fine. The same command you just run, you have to run every certain minutes in order to get this information over here, okay. Now I would like to run this one at every 1 minute, example say that, okay, star 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 star, and paste this file, that's it, and save it. Your index file, index maker, you have to use this one. And maybe if you have if you want a single device, that's why I'm just specifying is that single column I want, I don't want to multiple to be generated on the HTML page. Use this mrtg configuration file to generate this index slash var wwhtml, index.html is the page I want to generate this HTML page. So this HTML page will be generated, and whenever you are browsing this one, so you will get the different page over here. So this is your mrtg configuration path, this is your mrtg graphs. So you have to wait for a certain time to generate your mrtg graphs, and you can see that some data over here. Or if you want to customize this page, you can also customize this if you know a little bit about the HTML language, and or you can also use HTML and index.html page over here. This over here you have to change. Example say that I don't want this or on the bottom, like example say you can see this stuff, right? I don't want that page. Example, say this MRTG logo I don't want here, I want to keep a different one. Maybe you can keep that as well. So I just delete this attachments from here. Now save this one and go to that web page and browse, which goes away like that. You can remove this MRTG graph and all the stuff. You can customize this page and you will get some data after some time. That's it. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.